Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. It's Serica, and today I'm going to be doing my usual weekly spread in my bullet journal. As usual, I am creating my very basic blocks using my small ruler, and I'm just doing 5 lines for each of the boxes, and then I'm creating a column for all of the dates on the left-hand side, which is 4 boxes across. And a lot of you have told me that you've been inspired by this very minimal layout and you love it. I've been getting a lot of people tagging me in their recreations on Instagram, and I just absolutely love that. If it's working for you, take a picture of your weekly spread and tag me, because I would love to see what everyone's coming up with. People are taking the basic layout, which is of course modeled off of the free weekly memo insert from the Traveler's Company, and they've been putting their own spin on it. Maybe they're using their own handwriting or their own script to do all of the headers and the dates, and I just absolutely love that. This week I am using a really vibrant yellow fountain pen ink in my matching yellow fountain pen, and both of these things are from Ferris Wheel Press. I am so in love with this yellow shade, and I've used it in a couple of my previous bullet journal spreads, but I haven't recorded a spread for YouTube using this color. So it'll be interesting to show you some of those bright, vivid highlights that I'm going to incorporate into the decoration stage of this video. Now I am writing all of the tasks that I know I'm going to be doing this week and some of the other things I've got going on. I don't know what I'm doing every single day, especially not the weekend, but I do know that on Friday I'm going to be reopening my shop. So basically all week I'm going to be working hard on getting my shop ready. I'm going to be restocking all of my clear binder clip and push pin stickers, my bulldog clip stickers, clothespins. All of those classics are going to be restocked, and I'm going to be releasing some new designs as well. I'm retiring some old designs that aren't quite my art style anymore, so that's really exciting. I'm so ready to get my shop back up and running, especially because a lot of you have been asking me where I got my clip stickers, and they were available in my shop and they will be once again. Stay tuned for that on Friday. Besides that, I am just going to be doing my YouTube video production. I feel like I've been on a roll with them and I want to keep that going for as long as I can. I'm really glad that things are kind of just picking up and it feels good to be productive again. I didn't really have a plan going in. The only things I knew were that I wanted the color scheme to be warm, and I wanted to use some of the stamps and ephemera that evoked an old world literature and letter writing and postcard theme. Back when I was doing my art spreads in my bullet journal every month, that was definitely more of a planned out composition, but I found that with the traveler's notebook and with collaging and putting things together, it's definitely more about the process. Even though there were some mishaps, I think that just learning to let go of perfectionism, going with the flow, layering things, maybe keep playing around with it and see where it takes you. similar to last week, I just wrote down the few things that I really want to focus on for the week. And then I also did some writing on the side, just some thoughts I have about patience and waiting and times where you can't really rush the results of things. For example, I'm waiting for this baby, and I'm also waiting for a couple things that I want to find out about in my life. So if you're in a moment in your life where you're just kind of stagnant or you're kind of in this waiting period, you know, do what you can. And it's important to have patience, and we can all be patient together. I could have put this little bit of writing in my personal journal, but to be honest, all of my notebooks, even though they each have a separate purpose, they kind of bleed into each other. Like, I will maybe put a list in my personal journal, and then in my art journal, I'll do some collaging. So even though there's different titles, they kind of just merge sometimes. So I'm a little bit more flexible. I don't really compartmentalize completely. Alright, so that is my completed bullet journal spread for this week in October, and I'm really happy with the warm color palette and the letter writing look. Even though there were some mishaps, I'm glad that it turned out the way it did. And until the next video, I wish you all happy journaling, happy planning, and I'll see you next time. Bye!